Greetings fellow earthlings, in this video I decided to do something a little bit different, and that was with my audio. My audio is going to sound a little bit different in this year, so you should no longer hopefully hear that sound that goes on with these headsets I use. And yeah, I've done that differently. I'm still trying to improve my audio. I'm using Audacity at the moment, but there's going to be, I don't want to say a big video, but there's not going to be a big video. It's going to explain everything, is what I'm trying to say. It's just going to explain as much as I can about how annoying my audio is getting. It sent me completely mad, but I think I fixed it. Please tell me below if you think it sounds any better. I think it sounds massively better. I hope you think it does as well. Also, I haven't been uploading much, mostly because my audio has been annoying. But also, I'm running out of time as well. I'm back at university tomorrow, just checking my panda calendar over there, and I decided to do this Ryzen 4 video. I've been talking for a minute already. That's not good. Decided to do this Ryzen 4 video, and also I want to say there's a few changes being made into my channel, like these intros with my good looking face, as you can see here. I'm wanting to do intros, not with every video, just with some of them. This one wouldn't have one, but I want to explain all the audio stuff that's going on. And also, before we start the actual Rise and Fall video, I just want to mention, I was using my old microphone, however the stand didn't work right, so it was to remove the static sound. So I put it into a Kleenex box of tissues, and yeah, I just thought it was really funny how this was my YouTuber's technology microphone in a Kleenex box of tissues. Anyway, hope you enjoy this Ryzen 4 video, and goodbye. Greetings fellow earthlings, and welcome to my most difficult challenge yet on Ryzen 4. One versus one, just the normal small map that I like, Corridor of Blood. It's just a normal one versus one battle, but on M for difficulty, the hardest difficulty that you can get on this game. I'm going to try it on a 1v1, playing as Greece versus Rome. Greece is my favourite nation, and yeah, it's an idea, might as well just begin. Hopefully I can win. It's my biggest challenge on Rise and Fall yet. I don't know how it's going to go. I might not even survive. I don't have a clue what's going to happen. I've done this before, and I've won, but I don't have a clue what happened then. It was just some miracle how everything went perfect, and it was quite a while ago, but yeah. This is my chance to prove that it wasn't just a one-off miracle. Am I just brilliant at everything? If I win this, then it's clear that that is true. Is it on charge here? It's on charge control. Right, no, we need to start very quickly, because the AI is going to be very good. I want to get these two working immediately onto that wood, so that we can build our glory statues. I'm just going to assume, for the sake of a video, that you know how to play this game. Right, then we want, we'll go for 11 workers. It's usually 10 or 12. Greece, I prefer to go 11. Rome, 10 early on, but then I'll start training some later on. Egypt and Persia I don't usually play as, so that's, it's different. Also, my audio's changed a bit. I'm having to use my older microphone, but it actually works better because I don't have all that sound going on in the background. Hopefully that's been removed. There's still some problems that are caused by this older microphone, but yeah, those I couldn't get rid of. Hopefully it's not going to be too bad. That's all I have to say. Right, good, we've got a drain rebuilt. We can now start building our glory statue. So once we get 200 on her, we can get one of our advisors. That should get there very soon. Come on. Right, once we get Alexander, we're going straight towards the enemy. Right, let's go for him. Oh, and once this work is done, I want him to work on wood. So you can hold down shift and right click, and it's just like Cossacks like that. Employ the botanist. I pronounced that wrong, but oh well. Increases wood gathering rate, which is good. Right, try and avoid the outpost, just walk around it. My king. Right, you've built Eric the statue. Very well. You go there. Got a worker. Don't. Yes, we do have enough on it there. Build another glory statue. Try and explore much of the land as well as we go. I'll get that extra bit of honour. I love how these things are built. This they become three-dimensional. Right, attack the enemy very quickly. Hurry up, Alexander, our hero. Hurry up. Right, the enemy's somewhere around here. They sometimes build a settlement up this way. So if I have outbomb to go and destroy that. It's all about getting an early attack to get that head start of them. Yeah, here they go. Once we destroy that, that's an extra 200 wood that we'll be in the lead by. So it's mostly necessary. If I don't do that, I probably won't win. Oh, that reminds me of them. I want to get that. Yeah, just six of those should do. Keep a bit of gold spare for these glory stack tubes. I need to rely very heavily on those stat tubes. We'll almost have enough wood for another one as well. Come on, Alexander, destroy that. Right, you go here. You go here just to explore more of the map. Get that extra bit of honour. Hopefully we should reach 500 soon. Then we'll be able to upgrade Alexander and explore down here as well. Yeah, halfway through destroying that. Right, you two have done. Come back, and now you can come back as well. And once you have explored down there, you can return as well. That's almost destroyed. Yep, that's all that done. Right, so we've explored the local area. We're falling behind on the statue. Quickly build two of them there. Get to work on some hoplites. Have you destroyed this yet? Almost. Is it down? Come on, hurry up. There we go. That's dead. The destruction of Rome begins. I won't be able to wipe them out like this, but I'll definitely be able to do a bit of damage. Right, they're gonna die from that. So I'll leave them to it. Right. Can we kill at least one citizen and then run away? Running away now. Oh, quickly get out of there.
Your hero is badly wounded.
Don't die. Don't die. Please don't die. Right, I'll hide him over here for now. Just let him heal. He survived, that's the main thing. As long as he survived, then we'll be ready to upgrade him very quickly. Start with going for the wood. One more glory statue. I didn't want to, but I think, yeah, I kind of think I need to. Just to make sure I do have the honour. Stay over here. Oh wow, you can rotate it with holding left and right click down. Never knew that. It's amazing what you find out about computer games that you love and play all the time, and after hours and hours you just find something new. Oh, that's really nice. I'm really happy I discovered that. Statue completely worthless, lady. But very well. It's just something new that it adds. Let's have a look around our village then. Ooh, look at those statues from this different angle. Oh wow! Anyway, yeah, it's all fine. Alexander should heal up eventually. We should get him some stamina as well, then we turn into hero mode. Again, I'm just going to assume that you understand perfectly everything that I'm on about, even though if you haven't played Rise and Fall, this is just madness to you. I want to take an outpost as well. Bring Alexander back home. I think he's got enough health to make the journey. Go to hero level 2. We want to upgrade both of these. Or do we want improved? Yeah, we'll go for the improved gold mining, mate.
Not enough gold.
Yeah, well, we're running out of gold, so that's good. Then we want to upgrade our hoplites and our swordsmen. And then finally, we would want to get this here, weaponsmiths. Upgrades attack of spearmen. And then we can start going for some outposts. Get our. Oh, God. Recruitment points up. Right, avoid the outpost. I played as Rome yesterday. I barely play as Rome. It was interesting. They have a really weird advisor tree. It's strange. It doesn't feel Roman. Like, you don't get much military massive advantages. There's a few, but you don't get enough of them, I don't think, from Rome. Anyway, I'll be wanting to build another barracks. Just here. Seeing as well where... We've just got the wood to throw at it, then also I want a Spartan Academy in it. Build that there. And well, yeah, we're at 250, so we'll get that. And now we're now waiting for 750 on it, so that we can upgrade again, Alexander get some more stuff, and so on. Once both of these technologies are done, then we'll go. I think I'll take this one first. Moderately garrisoned, moderately. Yeah, they're all moderately garrisoned. Well.
Barracks complete.
I want a trainer out as well. I won't bother with Spartans yet. I think I'll just go for the trainer. Right, advance. Let's take this outpost, soldiers. Yeah, they're following me. I didn't want them to like start walking off some different direction. That would have been annoying. Can I try and lead them over here?
We're under attack!
Right, I'm moving and kill the archers, just to get these out of the way with. Try and hit the outpost a couple of times as well, weaken it.
Your hero is badly wounded.
Yeah, we've done it. Yeah, we should take the outpost. We want more units. We need more gold. We're almost at 750, so that's good. Right, the outpost is ours. Reform with our army. Got some extra gold as well, that should come in handy later. I want to take this one next and then build a wall here, because the enemy will try and land by sea and that will just mess us up. We don't want that to happen. These are so much cheaper when playing as Greece. When it's Rome, it's like 25 wood and then 70 gold, but you get about 25 gold off when playing as Greece, which is good. I think we have better archers as well. Don't know about the cavalry. I rarely use cavalry. I just don't like them as much. Anyway, as long as we have more outposts from them throughout the entire game, then we're doing well. Apart from the sea one, we won't bother with the sea one. That's it could completely change the entire game around, but I'm just going to rely on the thought that it wouldn't. We need more runners, so we'll be wanting to go into battle soon.
Units.
Right, are we ready? We'll wait for that to build up to 1,000 first, to the stamina points. Need more gold. We need more runner. We just need more of everything right now. And we just need to wait until it builds up eventually. Hopefully. Good, so we want this one. This is good as well, but we don't need it yet. 400. We're about 200 away. And I also want to upgrade as well, don't I? So we'll upgrade those to 75 on her. We're spending a little bit too much. But as soon as this is upgraded, we'll go for this. Hopefully take that down. And then we can move on. Then this one's the next target, then this one. We'll probably have met Rome by this point. Then we'll go for this one, then we'll lock down this area here. We might go around this way, or we might just push forwards, I don't know yet. Depends on the situation. Seeing as though we've got loads of spare wood, we might as well just upgrade that. Right, come on, soldiers. We'll leave our trainer behind, we don't need him in battle. We need more soldiers. Men. Go for it. Charge. Go back into hero mode. Need for charge. Right, it's the same centurions and archers again. These girls die archers die. It should get easier every single time because we're getting more and more soldiers. Well, better soldiers, more soldiers. I think that should do. Is everything okay? Yes, good, we've reached that 400. That means we're going to get loads more resources now. We can build a wall here to stop them coming by sea. Go for this one next, as I've said before. Get workers working with gold.
Not enough gold.
Sir? We'll send these two to it as well. And stuff delivered. There we go. You go work over there. Right, so we should double our gold rates now. I don't really need that yet. I would want archers later, but I don't need them now. Not when I'm just taking outposts. Oh yeah, that's it. I wanted to build a wall. Just build it across here. Stop them from passing through. There we go. Need more hoplites, right? How is this look? We'll go for this. This is already most of the dead. One soldier's finished you off.
Your hero.
We've got that taken down. Just need more soldiers. Want to upgrade again eventually. That costs $1,000. It's a long way until I'm gonna get there, but over. Yeah, good. I can see the gold rates rising now. Loads more gold. What do I want now? Could do with another glory statue. Seeing as our gold levels are good again.
My king?
Yeah, I'll go for a glory statue and just place it there. Rome taken this one yet? It'll be interesting to find out. No, that means I'm ahead of them, good. I can't enter hero mode yet, it's not there yet. Should be very soon. There we go. Oh, I lost it. I lost it, got stabbed. There we go. Playing.
Your hero was badly wounded.
There we go, that's good. We did take another settlement, but let's just reclaim it. There we go. We can build another statue. More soldiers. Start upgrading our archers a little bit now. Actually, not yet. Pull back a bit. You work over there. I'm sure Dunn, you can work over there. Got loads of gold.
Not enough gold.
Even though he just said not enough gold, we've still got loads of gold. We do. I want my archers as well soon. Shall I build a third barracks? Yeah, I think I will. To send Alexander forward just to take a look, see what's happening over here. If this outpost is weak, I'll go for it. If not, then I'll just defend over here. Yeah, it's weak. Good. Take advantage of the situation. Well, lots of civilians around as well. Destroy this ballista they're trying to build. Destroy the ballista. And I'll take the outpost. Bringing in reinforcements. Don't think I need more troops there yet. Actually, just defend this one, I think. That'll be best. I get some archers. Might as well go for that then if I'm getting archers. You just defend here. Try and destroy these ballistas in hero mode. Take this one out first. Soldiers and try to fry them. Yes.
Your hero is
back. That's good. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Good, we've got three barracks working very well. Loads of soldiers. This is all safe. How's the battle looking? Well, it looks like we're pushing them back a little bit. Our heroes getting weaker. I don't like that ballistas. Get my hero out of there. And send him for the legions. Just hold your ground, soldiers. Just hold your ground.
Your hero is badly wounded.
He's dead. At the worst time as well. But we're gonna have to send in some more soldiers. Leave our trainer behind though. Could do with another trainer. Want to train the archers. We're losing the outpost. We need to get there quickly. Come on. Some of these archers as well.
Gold. We're under attack!
How are these doing up here? I don't know what we were trying to do. Run, soldiers, get a move on. We need you there now. We have enough honour, but we have to wait until Alexander's back alive until we can do anything about it. That's why I really wanted him alive. Now we just gotta wait. Watch it build up. Actually, I'll improve morale as well. Whilst I'm waiting. Waiting to upgrade. Upgrade is what I mean. Here we go, he's back. Bring him with the army. Take the outpost. This is level 10 difficulty. This is the hardest it can get in a 1 versus 1. Of course you can have more opponents fighting against you, that can increase difficulty, but well, it will increase difficulty of course because you're just even more outnumbered, but come on soldiers. Right, flank around. Bring the archers, push them a little bit further up. Bring down the settlement. These soldiers tear down the ballistas.
Not enough gold.
We're bringing it down. Also doing some type of dance as well. We should just be able to hold this with our spearmen and our archers for now. Send in some reinforcements. Don't want to destroy that tower yet, I don't have the armor for it. Just hold this section down. Bring in reinforcements. We don't have many spearmen. We've got some spearmen coming. As long as we don't take this, I'm happy. As long as we can just hold them back here for now, we should eventually win. Oh, archers, I didn't say move forwards. Try and just help out, it's taking it. Take it back again, once you've sorted things out. I'll just let them do what they need to do. Send these here. Send in some more pikemen, Alexander. Even there. I also want to upgrade my soldiers once these pop up. Almost there. There. And what do we want then? Self heal. Improve morale, and we'll go for level 5 as well. Got lots of honour now. Honour's not a problem. Just hold your ground. You soldiers come over here, see what you can do on this front. You archers can fill up the space. Move here so that you can keep on firing. Take down the settlement. We're also trying to build it back up. Right, cavalry just walked through my archers. Don't get too close actually, just stay back a little bit, let the spearmen do most of the work. Take down the tower. We need more spearmen. 121, yeah, that should help. Oh, heroes died. Oh well, at least we clicked that button. Forwards. Oh, we're running out of spearmen now. Nope, hold your ground. Right, we don't have the strength to take the outpost yet. try and just destroy the stables and then we'll be done. And leave them up here for a little bit. I don't want you going too far into the city. Not until we have reinforcements. Speaking of reinforcements, we're almost here. I might go for the outpost first, but... no archers, don't go into melee, just fire your arrows. I don't know what to do. We'll go for the outpost one, we'll go for the outpost. I want to go for the outpost, so I'm going for the outpost. Need some more spam and reinforcements. Oh, these are just going to get slaughtered by that catapult. Take a catapult then. Seeing as though this is a government centre, it's not going to produce enemy soldiers. It's just going to... I don't know what it does really. I think it just gives them more taxes. Taxes as in money type taxes, not the little things that drive around. Almost level 5. Okay then, soldiers, I know you want to see you doing it, so just push forwards, you might as well. We're gonna do it anyway, right, looks like things. We'll take the outpost at the same time, split our forces into two. It's not the best decision, but we'll take a risk. Right, send in reinforcements. In this city, I want to just... I want to upgrade them in this city. Yeah, we took the outpost. Alright, that looks it. I'm getting my words mixed up as everything's going on. Hopefully the audio sounds okay. Yeah, we've won this. I am brilliant. It wasn't just a coincidence that happened once. I am brilliant. There's no other explanation for it. Bringing in reinforcements now. Upgrade, upgrade. What do we want from here? Increases number of... yep, blah blah blah. Moves blowing it up in the air. Yeah, we'll go for those. Army. We'll keep Alexander back a bit. There's no need sending him in now. We've already won. Archers are taking a bit of a hit though. Destroy the tower. Yeah, I think it's our archers that I've saved us. Archers and spearmen. Good combination as Greece. As Rome, probably need a few swordsmen in there. As well, legions or centurions. Swordmen's depleted. Relocate them to here. Actually, here would be safer. We're under attack! Yep, the tower's gone. Just disappeared. I wish we made a rise and fall too. That would be good. Just adding a few more nations for more modern computers. It would be brilliant. Such a good computer game. I don't mind about the graphics, I think the graphics are great. I'm one of those people who doesn't realise the graphics. It's like it could be HD or it could be something made in the 1960s. I hardly even noticed the difference. But something that extreme I can notice, but you get what I'm on about. Anyway, we're pushing them back now. This was the original city, now we're moving into a small town they've had to build on the edge. We're just gonna smash this up there, kill them all. Death to the Romans. Yeah, we've upgraded into our Royal Arch and Royal Phalanx. Loads of spare honour. We'll just research Spartans just for fun. Yeah, we haven't even upgraded into a town defence or a government centre yet, so that's interesting. Well, it's not the most interesting thing in the world, but it's still interesting. Right, push forward, destroy this tower, and then that should definitely be it. We'll probably surrender soon. Kill that civilian as well. So I'll send in a band of 63 hoplites as reinforcement, just to make sure they're not rebuilding themselves here as I'm marching this way. Destroy the tower. Come on. I'm going to... Yes, they've surrendered. They've surrendered. I'm going to finish them off. Just have fun. I doubt we've got any boats, but I'll check anyway. Might as well just keep the slaughter going for now. Ah, I've won anyway. They didn't even capture this outpost. Oh, that's bad for them. That's probably why they did so bad. They didn't even get any boats out to capture this one as well. I was expecting at least a couple of tri-beams around here at least. No, luckily I attacked them quickly, got loads of honor, got upgrades and just slaughtered them. And let's just quickly check the statistics. If it hasn't crashed, there we go. I saved timeline for last. I entered level 2 two times quicker than they did. Level 3 about the same. They didn't even get into level 4, that was a big problem. They ran out of honour, they couldn't upgrade the soldiers, they couldn't get the technologies, they just, of course, were going to die. Some of it overall. They had a better economy, but I had better military by a long way. And everything else was better for me. Yeah, they had more citizens. I did more research, though. We'll try economy next. Yeah, they just had more resources, I had more recruitment points and glory, but they beat me on everything else. Miscellaneous, yeah, I always win these. I don't think the AI can win. 804 mouse clicks. Wow. That's good. Military, I killed 731 units, lost. We'll just round that to 400. So that's our 1.8 ratio, is it? Yeah, that 1.8, I don't know. Then they lost. Yeah, that's strange. They lost more units than I killed, but that must be to do with the outposts. So they had bad luck there. And clearly, you could tell by that last one remaining. My army was bigger. Now it's time for the timeline. It would have been here when I attacked our settlement. You can see a small dip. Then they were messing about with the outposts. Then they started going up, but it was too late. I was just flying at this point. Because I took the outposts. Really important to get early on. And this was when I took their first outpost from them. I recovered a bit, and then I held my ground, taking that settlement, pushing up that hill to the other one, and eventually slowly broke into my city, and then it all just went downhill. Where that's for me, it's been up and up and up. Army size, it shows the same stuff. It's civilian count. I lost a few around here due to mistakes and outposts and stuff. Then it was here when I started killing them. Killing and killing until they ran out. So, hope you enjoyed this video. Rise and Fall is a brilliant game. It's just brilliant. It means so much to me as well. This and Cossacks and Warrior Kings battles, even though I've never recorded Warrior Kings battles, it's still up there with them. Unfortunately, I cannot record that on Windows 8.1. But if I ever become a millionaire YouTuber and can just throw money into a Windows 7 laptop just to throw away at the end of the day or something ridiculous like that, I will play Warrior Kings battles because it deserves it. Anyway, hope you enjoyed this video and goodbye.